and enhorsement, because they are very strong.
All right, now I got a precept to that. All right, because that's just exactly since I don't know how long, that's exactly how our people have been. Right, 2/3 of our people always been on that wicked shit. Oh, let's go join the heathen, man. There's a bunch of them, man, and they eating good over there. This is 1 Maccabees chapter 1 verse 11. In those days went there out of Israel wicked men who persuaded many, saying, let us go and make a covenant with the heathen that are round about us. For since we depart from them, all right, and this is our departure from the heathen, us coming out here doing this work. But you got people that turn back and go back to Egypt, man. For since we departed from them, we have much sorrow. So those are people with lack of faith, man. When shit hit the fan, man, they're going to go running back to Egypt, man. It's running to the so-called white man for salvation, man.
Come on. You being in this truth, you having this hope of faith, you should already know that ain't going to be no rest in this kingdom. That ain't going to be no rest from the part from the world. You should already know that. You should have faith and hope that the Most High is going to get you through it.
This is wisdom of Solomon, chapter 5. Verse 14, for the hope of the ungodly is like dust that is blown away with the wind, like a thine forth that is driven away with the storm, like as the smoke which is dispersed here and there with a tempest and passeth away, as the remembrance of a gust that tarry but a day.
Just kill all that right now. Read that part one more time,
huh?
That was beautiful.
This is wisdom of Solomon. Chapter 5, verse 14. For the hope of the ungodly is like dust.
Alright, so all y'all people out there that say you trust in God and you don't have this truth, man, your prayers ain't reaching past your head. You know, that's what they used to tell us back in the segregation days, man. We was out there protesting and we was out there praying for deliverance. But this devil treating us the way he was treating us. And the devil used to say to our people, man, what you praying to God for? Your prayers don't reach past your head. Straight up. So but 2/3 of our people, but what little did he know, he's the ungodly motherfucker. Alright? And 2/3 of our people are just like that, are counted as dogs. Because they try to follow behind this devil. But ain't no peace with this devil, man.
No peace, ain't no rest.
They call on his name.
Keep going about the shepherd. A refuge in times of trouble.
In the times of trouble, what trouble, man? You know what I'm saying? When Yahweh shall make a return. You know what I'm saying? When everything start going down, man, Jacob's trouble, the race rights, you know what I'm saying, so forth. Keep going about the shepherd.
And they that know thy name.
Come on. And the Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans are the true Israelites of the Holy Bible. Son name is Yahweh Shai. If you're not calling on those names, you know what I'm saying, you can't be saved. Who gonna save you? Gandhi got down, even though he's not a god, but he was teaching some other shit. Buddha, goddamn Allah, No,
I know, oh, I know what's gonna save them. The missiles. I mean, that's what, that's their salvation, though. That's the purification, though.
Come on, you know, true point. You know what I'm saying? That's the only way that they can get in the kingdom, man. You know what I'm saying? That is their savior. Because those missiles don't come, they still gonna be in this shit.
So hey, y'all pray to the, y'all pray to North Korea and Russia. Pray to their ICBMs. Hey, because you know they got the power of Yahweh Shim Yahweh Shai in them, that fire.
And serve other gods. Wherefore I will deliver you no more. Verse 14. Go and cry unto the gods which ye have chosen.
So y'all Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans that still calling upon Jesus, sweet Jesus and Jehovah,
sweet baby,
and all that, calling on God, he gonna make you call, man, the Most High gonna look you, his son gonna look you dead in your eye. Dead in your eyes, say, call upon your other gods. I will not help you. Can you imagine that? Being that, now that's real fear. Being in a dreadful situation and having nobody to deliver you from that. No hope.
Fear, and that's real heartbreak too, man. You know what I'm saying? Not your other half. Not your spouse leaving you. Nothing. You know what I'm saying? That's your spouse, man. You know what I'm saying? That's your husband, man, right there, saying, nah. Call on who you been calling on, man. That's true heartbreak right there, man.
We do that all the time. Let us catch our bitch talking to another dude. You know what I'm saying? Or dealing with another dude. And then when that dude shit on her, she go to calling you back. What you do? Nah, don't call me. Call that nigga you been calling.
Yeah.
That's exactly what the Lord finna do, man. All praises to Yahweh by Shimmy Yahweh Shai.
Come, because I got a quick preset right there.
Bring it out. You go ahead to your.
Yeah, my bad. Let them deliver you in the time of your tribulation.
God, because the tribulation that's going to come right now, that's going to come right now, is Jacob's trouble, man. Jacob's trouble is arising right now, man. They getting these demon camps ready for you, Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. And you're confusing the faces, man. They're going to be rounding y'all up and throwing y'all in them concentration camps. That's coming right now, man. Somebody get,
Revelation 7:14. Come on. And just to add on, man, speaking of FEMA, man, you know what I'm saying? After the hurricane just hit down here, you know what I'm saying? Looking on social media, you just got all these Jake women, you know what I'm saying? Those are the dependents. You know what I'm saying? All that, they just on that, how many of y'all called FEMA and got that $500 check? You know what I'm saying? Like, the brother, when we get to sit down, man, FEMA, that's what we're saying, people rounding your ass up. They go down to Egypt for help, man.
This weekend, they were rounding people up over there in Washington Heights. They had a curfew out there.
Come on.
Curfew was 8 o'clock out there. You got called out there. You got ID, search and seize. You got called out to 8 o'clock out there, man.
Come on. All right, this is Revelation 7:14. And I said unto him, sir, thou knowest. And he said to me, these are they which came out the great tribulation, and have washed their robes, and made them white in the blood of the Lamb.
God, man, because at the end of the day, man, you know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, the elect men, the 144,000, the 1/3 of the children, they ain't gonna be the ones that's gonna be found in the book of life when Yahweh by Shem Yahweh Shai come back. Them are the ones that's gonna survive the famine, the pestilence, the nuclear missiles, man. Survive the truth. Though you're gonna have some brothers that's gonna be martyred for not taking the chip, right? They're gonna be mighty and stand up for the word boldly for Yahweh by Shem Yahweh Shai, and they still gonna make it, man. But at the end of the day, you know what I'm saying? Them are the ones that's gonna make it, man. Right? That's why the scripture said, take up the cup of salvation, man. Because our salvation is in Yahweh by Shem Yahweh Shai, man. That's why we cleave unto this word, man. That's why we incline our ears unto the words of Yahweh by Shem Yahweh Shai, man. Bring up the next scripture off of Arkansas.
It's Jeremiah. Chapter 30, verse 7.
Come.
Alas, for that day is great.
That day is great, man. This time that's gonna come, right? Because at the end of the day, you Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans are the biblical Israelites of the Holy Bible, man. Come. Turn back to your Lord and Savior, Yahweh Shai, man. The one that y'all even call God and Jesus Christ, because at the end of the day, Jacob's trouble is coming, man. The economy of America is crumbling, man. The dollar is not the world currency no more, man. Real soon, these FEMA accounts are going to be open, and they're going to be rounding up people to take that chip, which is the RFID chip, which is the mark of the beast. Spoke about in Revelations, man. Keep going.
Alas, for that day is great.
It is great, man. So it's going to be a lot of killing, a lot of death. It's going to be actually purged on the streets of America. Why you think they burned that movie out, man? That movie was very subliminal, man. Especially in the part when there was gathered up in the neighborhoods and they were rounding up people in them little in them trucks and killing them. They coming to the hoods and killing y'all, man. That day finna be so great, man. Keep going.
So that none is like it.
It's gonna be worse than the time of Egypt. It's gonna be worse, man.
Worse than
9/11. Keep going.
It is even the time of Jacob's trouble.
It's even the time of the Jacob's trouble. Keep going.
But he shall be saved out of it.
So you're going to have some Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans that elect women and children and the men that stand up boldly for the word of Yahweh. So you're not going to make it out of it. But your birth is going to perish in that time, man. But that's why y'all don't want to hearken to the men of the Lord, man. Y'all want to hear that trumpet that's being blown, man.
For it shall come to pass in that day, saith the Lord of hosts, that I will break his yoke from thy neck, and I will burst thy bonds, and strangers shall no more serve themselves of him.
Come, man. Ain't gonna serve ourselves of him no more, man. So at the end of the day, man, Yahweh Shemiah Shah, man, he's gonna bring down the hammer, man. He's gonna be, all judgment is gonna come to the shores of America, man, which is referred as the mother of heartless, man.
This is Revelation, chapter 3, verse 10. For God thou hast kept the word of my patience. I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation.
So come, man, so that elect men, women, and children, we're going to keep the word of Yahweh by some Yahweh shot, man. You know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, man, wisdom and knowledge should be the stability of y'all time right now, man. Y'all supposed to be watching the prophecies that's going on. You seeing the earthquakes. You see the hurricanes, man. You see what happened to Houston, man. On top of that, two more hurricanes coming to the shores of America, man. You got Lee and you got Mariah. That's coming to the shores of America, man. So at the end of the day, you have wildfires happening over there in the West Coast. A lot of things are shaking up. Race-wise is coming up.
Earthquakes in Mexico.
God, man. You had this rapper, I don't know how to say his name, Triple X. He did a video of hanging up, eating my baby, man. And Jake was watching, man.
X-Tentacion.
X-Tentacion, man. That's race. The race riot is gonna come, man. And y'all, hey, the scriptures is speaking, man.
We shall come upon all the world.
We should come upon the whole world, man, because real soon that RFID chip is going to be made mandatory, man. And you better not take that chip or you're going to be destroyed by nuclear missiles, man. Somebody get Revelation chapter 14, verse 9. Babaka Shah, bring it up. Bring your scripture up.
To track him that dwell upon the earth.
To try them that dwell upon the earth, man. The whole earth is gonna be traveled to RFID chip. That's gonna be made mandatory, man, on the shores of America.
We try to schools you on less than kind of getting low on matters.
Yeah, one more time.
This verse 11. Behold, I come quickly. Hold that fast which thou hast.
Because Yahweh Shemiah, he's coming quickly. So for the men that have this truth, have this wisdom and knowledge and understanding, we need to hold on to this. Hold on to the word, man, not get caught up in philosophies. That no man take thy crown, man. This wisdom and not to understanding, man. Not being deceived, man. And pray that Yahweh Shemiah Shah don't enter you in temptation, man. All right.
This is Psalms chapter 40, verse 4.
God.
Blessed is the man that make of the Lord Yahweh by Hashem Yahweh Shah his trust.
Because at the end of the day, the men of the Lord from Jim Mitz all the way down, man, to the heads of the council, to the younger Akim, to the other camps that's under the umbrella of GMS. We made Yahweh Hashem Yahushua our trust, man. He's our strong tower, man. He's our protection. He's our help.
Keep going.
In respect, not the proud,
man. We don't respect Esau, man, these heathen nations. We don't respect 2/3 of you Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. They want to be a part of this world, this system, man. We don't respect Yahweh Hashem Yahushua, man. We obey the word of the Messiah, not man. Keep going.
Nor such as turn aside to lies,
man. So we're not going to turn to philosophies. Because the Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, and the confusing of faces, are the Israelites of the Holy Bible. Turn back to your Lord and Savior, the one that you can call God in Jesus Christ, which is his true name in the Paleo Hebrew. It's Yahweh Shah, man. Be watching and praying, man. Because what that roughly paraphrase the scriptures, when the Pharisees came up and they were saying that they was not fasting and praying, then Yahweh Shai said it's going to be a time when the Son of Man should not be here, then should they fast and pray. So right now, we're in a time right now, we should be fasting and praying, man. Staying in the spirit, man. Being spiritually sober. Keep going.
Watch and pray
God
that ye enter not temptation.
That ye should not enter not in temptation, man. Don't get caught up in Jacob's trouble, man. Getting caught up in the famine, the pestilence. Getting caught up in taking that chip, man. If I'm praying to Yahweh Hashem Yahushua right now, then he keep you from the hour of temptation. Because at the end of the day, he got our footsteps, man.
Bring it out one more time.
Let it clip it after this.
All right.
Behold, my servant shall rejoice, but ye shall be ashamed.
So his servants are going to rejoice. The men of the Lord and the women and children are going to rejoice in them days, man. Because why? Y'all despise the word, so y'all going to get what y'all deserve, man. Keep going.
Behold, my servant shall sing a joy of heart, but ye shall cry for sorrow of heart and shall have for vexation of spirit.
Yeah, man, y'all gonna be crying, man, bugged out in that day, man. All right?
Gonna make that a clip.
Yeah.